We've had lots of requests on how to paint the cloaks on Warhammer models, and especially how to achieve the blend from the darker recesses up to the lighter colours of the highlights. So in this video, we're going to show you exactly how to do just that, using a combination of the classic and contrasted Tadell paints. Now, for our demonstration, we're going to be painting the cloak of a Space Marine Primaris Captain, and as an Ultramarine, his cloak is going to be red, but these techniques will work on any colour scheme you choose to use. Now, the secret of painting a good cloak is to start off with a good strong base coat mid-tone and then work down into the recesses with the shades and then work up with the lighter colours on the layers and the highlights. So to help this out, we've undercoated it with Mechanica's standard grey spray. And the first thing we're going to do is to apply two coats of Blood Angel's red contrast paint, two coats to make sure the colour is really strong. So we're going to grab ourselves our medium shade brush, take a little paint from the pot like so. We're not thinning this down, we're just using the palette to make sure we're not overloading the brush. Then, on the back of our cloak, we're just going to paint Blood Angel's red all over the cloak. Now, it's important here, as you paint these layers on, that while it's drying, you're using the brush to move the paint around to avoid any areas of pooling on the model. It's going to take about 20 minutes for this coat to dry. Once it has, we'll apply a second coat, and once that's dry, we'll move on to the next stage. So there we go, the Blood Angel's red has dry on our cloak, giving us a really nice and even solid mid-tone base coat for us to work over. So it's time now to move on to the next stage, and for this we'll be shading into the recesses of our cloak. We're going to be using Flesh Terror's red contrast paint, mixed quite a lot with contrast medium. We'll be using quite a few stages of this as well to add a subtle blend into our recesses, but more on that in a second. First of all, let's mix up our first layer of Flesh Terror's red. So grab yourself your medium shade brush, and take a little bit of the contrast medium out of the pot like this. Now we're going to be mixing it onto our palette like so. We're about 4 or 5 brushfuls of contrast medium like so. Then wash the brush out and take about 1 brushful of Flesh Terror's red out of the pot and mix it in here. Actually, you know what? That's probably a bit too strong. So we're going to take a little bit more contrast medium. Wash your brush out fully when you're using contrast medium like this. You don't want to get any contaminated paint in there. So a bit more. There we go. Perfect. So now with the paint nice and thin, we're going to take our Space Marine miniature, we're going to apply it into the recesses of our cloak like so. Now, you can apply this quite thinly if you want to, or thickly if you'd like to, but the thinner you make it, the more subtle the blend will be. This is going to be a very subtle effect, but we'll add more coats of it as we go through. So you can see I'm adding quite a thick layer here. This is going to be quite subtle because it's been mixed with quite a lot of contrast medium. After this is dry, it'll take about 10 minutes to dry, but after it has, we'll add more coats, starting about here, and then here and here, going thin into the recesses of our Space Marine's cloak as we add more layers in. You'll want about 4 or 5 coats, but make sure you're doing it to taste, and you'll see a really good effect once you've done those layers. And there we go, we added about 3 or 4 layers of Flesh Terror's red into the recesses of our cloak there, and we've got this really cool subtle blend effect going on. But we also want to add a little bit more contrast into the recesses of our cloak, so we're going to add another paint, and again we use a contrast paint, this time Basilicanum Grey, mixed with contrast medium again. This time we're using a medium layer brush for a little more added control, so we're going to take a little bit of our contrast medium out of the pot like so, wash the brush off, and then just grab 1 brushful of Basilicanum Grey like that, nice and thin. Again, we're going to add nice thin layers of contrast medium mixed with Basilicanum Grey into the recesses of our Space Marine. So into the deep recesses, so we're looking here, and we're looking here. Add as many layers as you like. Remember, the more layers you use, the more colour you'll build up. I'm probably going to use about 2 or 3 layers here. And there we go, the Basilicanum Grey has dried in the recesses and our shading is complete. So now it's time to move on to the next stage of our cloak, and that's to add some layers on the raised areas. We're going to start off with Mephiston Red, mixed with Lamia Medium. Again, we're using medium here to thin our paint down, so the effect is very subtle. So, once again, we're using our medium layer brush here for a bit more control. Take a bit of our Lamia Medium out of the pot like so, mix it onto the palette like this, and then about three brushes there, then 1 brush full of Mephiston Red. Like so. Perfect. Nice and thin. Then, onto our miniature, we're going to take it onto the raised areas here on the very, very, very pinnacles of the cloak. So just a nice thin line here on the raised areas of the cloak. And the Mephiston Red has dried, giving this really cool effect on the raised areas of the cloak. So now it's time to finish the cloak off with a couple of highlights, and we'll be starting off with a highlight of Wild Rider Red mixed with just a little bit of Lamia Medium over the top of our Mephiston Red. And finally, a cheeky highlight of Troll Slayer Orange will go down as a sort of thin line highlight, giving a really cool sharp edge to our cloak. So let's start off with the Wild Rider Red mixed with Lamia Medium. We're going to take our medium layer brush again. There's a bit of medium out of the pot here. And we're going to mix it on our palette. Again, about two brushfuls there of Lamia Medium to one brushful of Wild Rider Red. Absolutely perfect. There we go. Now onto our miniature. We're going to be painting it on. This time, the highlights are going inside the Mephiston Red we've already painted on. So about there. Last but not least, we're adding a fine line highlight of Troll Slayer Orange, which we slightly thinned down with water. Use a medium layer brush here for a nice bit of control. Get a nice point on it and just drag the brush up the cloak in the center of the Wild Rider Red through to the top. And there we go with the final highlights applied. Our red cloak is complete. And that's how you paint cloaks on your Warhammer models using a combination of the Citadel Contrast and Classic paints. Something to remember here is always use mediums in this situation to thin your paint down. Using those means the pigment of your paint is stretched out and the paints dry with a much more subtle effect. Hope you found this video useful. Happy painting!